In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new with the Photos app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's get to what's new with the Photos app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. So I'm in my Photos app, and the first thing I want to point out is the sidebar here. Really, not a whole lot has changed here outside a few more collections. These are all called collections. But for the most part, everything here is pretty much the same. We can't customize this outside of, when I tap on edit here, we can't customize it outside of adding and removing albums. So we're not going to focus on this sidebar too much. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and hide this. To hide it, what we do is we tap on the little icon here. So let's go ahead and hide it. So what is new with the Photos app? Well, basically what they did is they redesigned this whole interface right here, outside of the sidebar, of course. What do I mean by redesign? Well, basically all of our different collections are available in here. You're going to see that I can see my recent days. This is a new collection. So I can see all the photos based on recent days. And if I tap on it, what it's going to do is it's going to open up a separate card. And now I can see all of those separate days. To go back, we tap on back. And now we're back at all of our different collections. I swipe up, I have more collections. We can see my pinned collections. I can see people. And I can see memories here. I keep swiping up. We also have featured photos, trips. I have my shared albums here. And then we have our media types as well as our utilities. So we have all of our different collections here, including another new collection, Wallpaper Suggestions. And again, all we have to do is just tap on this, and it'll show me that collection. I go back, and it takes me back to all of my different collections. Now, in addition to that, we can also customize and reorder these. Let's say that I didn't want to see Wallpaper Suggestions. I don't want to see this at all. But what I would like to do is I would like to move my trips here up towards the top, so it's beneath my library. Well, what we need to do is we just need to go to the bottom. You're going to see customize and reorder. I tap on it, and then from here all I have to do is just deselect what I want to hide. So I'm just going to deselect wallpaper suggestions here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to move trips here up towards the top. So I just drag it up there. So as you can see, we can reorder these. So now we have my trips up towards the top. From there, I also would like to have albums here up towards the top. So now I just drag albums. I don't want to see pinned collections. I want to see my albums there. And then I'm going to move pinned collections over to the left. We'll talk a little bit more about pinned collections here shortly. So basically what we're able to do is just kind of move these around. When I am done, I tap on done here, or the X. And now all those changes have been made. So when I go down to the bottom, you're going to see I no longer have my wallpaper suggestions. They're no longer there. And when I swipe up, when I look below my library here, this is the library. We'll talk about that in a minute. When I look below my library, you're going to see I have my trips, my albums, as well as my pinned collections there. So that's how we can customize our photos. I'm going to call it my photos homepage, I guess. But that's how we can go and customize that. Let's take a look at these pinned collections. This is a pretty nice little new feature as well. From here, what I'm able to do is select my favorites. I can go and select all of my different screenshots. Just tap on it, and you're going to see all of my screenshots. Tap on the X to close it. Let's take a look at my favorites. Tap on favorites here, and now I can see all of my favorite photos. Tap on the X. And what it'll do is it'll close it. So we have all of our different pinned collections there. And we can also modify these pinned collections. So what I'm going to do is tap on modify. And then from here, just like with our other collections, what I'm able to do is remove different collections here, pinned collections. And I can add other ones in here. And on top of that, what we're able to do is reorder them. So I use screenshots quite a bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move screenshots here up towards the top. So I just go and drag this up. We'll put it below favorites. And now when I tap on the X here, you're going to see that my screenshots are below my favorites, so I have easy access to them. So that's how we can access our different collections. Now let's take a look at the library and what is new with the library. If you're not familiar with the library is where all of your photos are located. So this is my library. These are my collections. So anything above it is my library. Anything below it are collections. So we're going to focus on this area here now. Now, when I want to go into the library, what I can do is I can just swipe down a little bit. So I'm going to swipe down, and you're going to see my collections disappeared. In addition to that, we have a new toolbar down here. So now I'm just focusing on my library. So what can I do here? Well, basically what I'm able to do is close this. This is going to close the library and bring us back to our standard interface. I can also view them by months. So when I tap on months here, you're going to see it's grouping all of my photos by month here, and I can just swipe up and down to view them. I can also view them by years. So we still have our month and year view. I tap on any one of them to see that year. To go back to all of my photos, I tap on all here, and what it'll do is it'll show me all of my photos. When I am looking at all of my photos, I have a new option. I'm able to filter these. Filter and sort, or change the view. This will disappear when I tap on one of these. So I'm going to go to months here, and you're going to see that this is going to disappear. So if you don't see it, it's probably because you're not looking at all. You have to tap on all here to show that option. So I tap on all, and now I tap on this, and you're going to see we have a few different options here. From here, I'm able to change my sort order. I can also set if I want to see both of my libraries. I do have a shared library here. Apple introduced that with iOS 17. And then we have filter and view options. Let's first take a look at filter. When I tap on filter, what I'm able to do is filter these photos in the library by a specific type. So I can easily see all my favorites. It's basically like looking at my collection, my favorites collection. But I can also see all of my edited videos, my photos, as well as just my screenshots. So that's how we can select what we want to see. We can only select one of these. We can't select more than one. We also have view options here. With view options, what we're able to do is actually hide different options. So what I would like to do is I would like to hide the screenshots. I don't want to see those in my library. They're still going to be in my library, but they're not going to be in this area here. I'm going to have to tap on that screenshot collection, which I showed you earlier. So I'm just going to go and hide those screenshots. I uncheck it. And now you're going to see that the screenshots are no longer there. So if you want to hide any of these options, you can do that as well. And then we also have zoom in and zoom out, as well as our aspect ratio. So I can easily zoom in and out, although I usually use pinch to zoom. And with the aspect ratio, this will just kind of show the photo in its full aspect ratio. So now we can easily see what the aspect ratio is. I like to have it in square when I'm looking at my library, so I'm going to put it back into my square photo grid. Tap on it. Now we're back at our square photo grid. So that's our library. So how do we get out of the library? Again, all we have to do is just tap on the X here. Or what I can do is I can just swipe up. And when I do, it takes me out of that library. So that's how we can manage our library. We do have a nice little search here, and if you use Apple Intelligence, it does use Apple Intelligence to search for different photos and videos. In addition to that, if you do have an iPad with Apple Intelligence, we can now create a memory movie. So I'm just going to swipe up here, and you're going to see that I have memories here. Now, this is an iPad that does have Apple Intelligence. So basically, all I have to do is just tap on here. I describe what I want to view. So I'm just going to go with beach. So we type in here beach, return. And now what it's doing is it's looking through all of my photos and videos, and it's going to create a memory based on this description. And it's using Apple Intelligence, and this is all on device, so it's not going out to the cloud to do this. And now we have my beach photos. So from here, what I'm able to do is favorite it, tap on the heart. I can give Apple feedback, give it a thumbs up, thumbs down. And when I am done, I just tap on done. And we have my new memory there, all based on Apple Intelligence. If you don't have Apple Intelligence, you will not have this create a memory movie option. In addition to creating a memory movie, we also have cleanup. With cleanup, what we're able to do is remove different items from a photo. So let's go back over to my library. How do we do that? Again, we just swipe down until we get to my library. And what I have here is this photo here. Let's go ahead and tap on it to open it up. I have this photo from our Alaskan cruise, and we have all of these different people in here. What I would like to do is I would like to remove those. This is where Apple Intelligence can come into play, cleanup with Apple Intelligence. And again, it does this all on device. What I need to do is I need to go and edit the photo. So I tap on edit down here in the bottom of the photo. We have our standard editing tools. Not a whole lot has changed here outside of cleanup. When I tap on cleanup here, what it's going to do is it's going to analyze the photo and it's going to look for objects that could be removed, including all of these people here. So what you're going to see here is it's downloading the cleanup. It has to do this initially, and it only has to do this one time. Now that it's downloaded the tools, it'll do the on-device cleanup. So I have it downloaded here. It's analyzing the photo, and what you're going to see here soon is all of these people are going to have like a little rainbow around them. And then from there, what I need to do is just need to tap on them to remove them. Let's go ahead and zoom in. So I'm just going to pinch to zoom in here. And we can see that they have a little glow around them. So let's just go ahead and start erasing these people. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap on her here. And when I do, you're going to see they disappeared. So I'm just going to tap on these people here. And they're going to slowly disappear as I tap on them. And I am removing those people. And we'll go over here to this area here. I'm just going to swipe around there a little bit, and you're going to see that they are removed. We have one more person over here. Let's just go ahead and remove them. And they are no longer there. Now we can also swipe to remove. So those are what Apple Intelligence detected. I wanted to remove those people. But let's say I also wanted to remove this little box here. All I have to do is just drag over top of it. And you're going to see that it'll remove it. When I am done, I just tap on done here. And all those objects and people are going to be removed. And now we can see they are no longer there. You can always revert back to the original. I can go back into edit mode, and then you're going to see revert here, and it'll bring everything back. So it's non-destructive photo editing. So that's how we can clean up a photo as well. It doesn't work with videos, but it works pretty good with photos, as you can see. So if you have some people in a photo and you want to remove them, that's how you can do that. Now you're going to see that I still have an arm in there. So let's just go ahead and remove that as well. We'll just do this real quick so you can see how easy it is. So I go back into edit mode. I tap on cleanup. You're going to see that it doesn't have to download it because it's already downloaded. And now you're going to see that it says just brush on what you want to remove. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this area here and brush on that. And we're going to zoom in to do that. So I just pinch to zoom in, drag in here what I want to remove. So I'm just going to drag in there. Like a paintbrush, basically. Not really drag, but I'm just painting what I want to remove there. And when I am done, I let go. And we can see it removed it. I tap on done here. And that is no longer there as well. Now, the last thing I want to show you is we have some new settings within the Photos app, including our sync status. Now, in the past, what we did is we looked beneath our library here for our sync status. Actually, I believe it was down at the very bottom. Well, we can see that it is no longer there. So how can we check our sync status for using iCloud Photo Library? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to tap on our little icon here in the upper right-hand corner. When I tap on that, you're going to see that we have access to a few different settings. From here, I'm able to see my sync status. And if it wasn't synced, maybe my iPad was in low power mode, I would be able to force sync it here. In addition to that, I can see what photos are shared with me. And I can also set my library view options. If you're using a shared library, do you want to see both libraries or do you just want to see one? Below that, we can set if we want to see our shared library activity or if we want to show our hidden album, which was introduced in iOS 17. And with our view options, we have autoplay motion as well as view full HDR. So if you don't like HDR, you can turn that off. And then we can also manage our shared library. And we can set if we want to see our showed feature content as well as holiday events. And then our last option here is for resetting. We can reset our suggested memories as well as reset people and pet suggestions. So in addition to having a few options within the settings app itself, which is where we would normally find these settings, Apple moved or added them over to our little icon here in the upper right-hand corner. I think it's pretty easy to access, and probably the use that I use it most for is for checking my sync status. So if I want to make sure that my photos are syncing, I would just tap on this, and then you're going to be able to see the sync status and force it to sync if you need to. So those are the new settings that we have available to us within the Photos app as well. So that is what is new with the Photos app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Basically, they redesigned the interface. It takes a little bit to get used to. I was a little hesitant at first, but now that I've played around with it and I've customized it how I want it to work for me, I actually find it pretty easy to use and I like it. I wasn't sure that I would like it at first. So what I would recommend doing is just kind of playing around with it and customize the Photos app to the way that you use the Photos app. If you don't use pin collections, remove them. If you don't use wallpaper, remove it. Maybe you use albums or shared albums quite a bit. Move those up to the top. I think you're going to find it a little bit easier to use in the long run, but it is going to be a little bit of an adjustment. Also, if you are using Apple Intelligence, you can easily create new memories, and you can use cleanup to clean up your photos. So that is what is new with the iPad, or I should say, that is what is new with the Photos app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can also share it with your friends or family. But even more than that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. I have over 400 videos on YouTube, but on my site, danstutorials.com, I have over 2,000. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have with YouTube. How can you help support my efforts? Well, my site, danstutorials.com, is a membership-based site. So when you become a member of my site, what I do for you is I take out all of the ads of the videos. You also have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And you have access to my classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office. I'm not part of some big organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting a small business. Check out danstutorials.com for more information. And thanks for watching.